So now I want to talk a bit about JavaScript object notation, otherwise known as JSON. So you can take a look at the interview that I did with Douglas Crockford about the discovery of JSON. The key thing, and he's very very humorous when he talks about this, JSON is not something that he really invented. It's really just part of JavaScript, and it's been sort of extracted from JavaScript in ways that are used outside of JavaScript. And it's a way to serialize data and transmit it from, say, PHP to JavaScript. And so it's a wire protocol, a serialized wire protocol, that just happens to be inspired by how constants are written in JavaScript. And so just to sort of review, JavaScript has two kinds of list container objects. The first is a list, which is just a linear zero-based list, sub 0, sub 1, sub 2, with square brackets as the constant and as the index operator, but it also then has objects, which are key value pairs. And the thing that's a little weird about JavaScript is that objects and associative arrays are kind of the same thing. They're just key value pairs. And so the thing that has confused me over the years, the thing that confused me over the years was that you could use syntax that looks like object-oriented syntax, like balls.soccer, or associative array syntax, balls sub quote lacrosse, and they are the same by the time it's all said and done. They are the key value pairs. And so this syntax, which in a language like Python or other, we'd think, oh, that's a dictionary, and there's a different language for objects. Well, this turns out to be an object in JavaScript. And that's not a big deal. It's just that after a while, you get a little confused. If you see somebody using the same thing with these two syntaxes, they're really equivalent. Okay. And so the JSON syntax is a simplification of the JavaScript constant syntax. And so you can have things like strings, you can have integers, you can have booleans, you can have a list or an array. So you use square brackets for lists and curly brackets for objects. And so you can nest these things. And so here we have an object named who, and it has an element or a member or a key of offices that itself is a list of strings. Here we have a key of skills, which itself is an object. So we have an outer object, and then we have inner object within it listed as skills. And so you can nest these as much as you want. You can have lists of objects or objects with lists, and it can go further and further. I mean, you could have in here, this could itself be another list or another object. So it can go as deep as it needs to go in a very hierarchical way. And so once this JSON syntax was identified as something useful to go across multiple languages, then it always worked in JavaScript, but then people built JSON libraries in languages like PHP and Java and C and C# and all these other languages so that those languages could generate JSON. And then the JSON could be consumed by languages. Now you could easily have a PHP talking to another PHP and they're exchanging JSON. It happens to be JavaScript syntax, but it's JSON, okay? And so there's really useful and great libraries inside most programming languages. So let's take a little look at a little bit of code. This is in json01.zip, zip in my PHP intro website. And the first thing I want to just show you is the syntax. Now, this is kind of a little weird in that this is JavaScript and this looks like JSON, okay? It's kind of the JSON I just showed you. This is executable JavaScript. This is the constant syntax, the syntax for defining constants in the JavaScript programming language. That's what it is. So who equals is just a variable, equals an object with these four keys in it, chuck, 29, true, a list of strings, and another object. And so it just window.console.log. So let's just sort of take a look at this. It's... Okay, let me clear this. JSON 01, JSON syntax, right? Now let me show the log. Okay, so this is now an object, right? And it just was JavaScript. It's executable JavaScript. So that's kind of the weird thing about JSON is not only is it a syntax for serialization and deserialization, it also is legitimately executable JavaScript. Crazy. And cool at the same time. Okay. So the next thing I want to show you. So that's how you kind of make JSON in JavaScript. But now I want to show you how you make JSON in PHP. And then how you pull JSON from the server and pull it into JavaScript. So the first thing I want to show you actually is this right here, this JSON.php. So this is a bit of code that creates a PHP code, JSON.php. It creates an array with the key first mapped to the string first thing, second mapped to the string second thing. And then it calls this built-in function. I mentioned that when JSON became popular, all these languages added JSON libraries. Well, PHP has it built right in, JSON underscore encode. What you pass in to JSON underscore encode is a PHP object or a PHP array. Whatever it is, it'll look through it, look through the hierarchy of it, and it will produce a string. So JSON encode returns a string with curly braces and greater than and square brackets and colons and quotes. That's legit JSON based on this. So it's as simple as, here is a PHP data item and give me the JSON representation for that. And then I echo it just to print it back out. So let's take a look at how that works. So if I just run JSON.php, it comes out as curly brace, first colon first and second colon second string. So this now is legit JSON. This is a JSON constant. And it is the output. So if I do a view developer console, now it takes a second. So if I do a network, and let me just hit refresh here. It takes a second because there's a sleep one on purpose there. Okay. Now this is all sort of extra junk. Don't worry about that. That's just CSS my browser's adding. So ignore that. The only thing that really matters is this. So I am hitting the URL JSON.php, I'm doing a GET request, it's a GET request to that, and the response is this, curly brace first, this is the output of my PHP, it's the output of the echo, the encode statement. So this is super powerful and super simple, so I keep saying it a bunch of times so that you get it right, super powerful and super simple. This is stuff is a PHP variable. JSON encode creates, gives you back a string with curly braces and quotes and colons and stuff. And echo just echoes that out. And that's exactly what we're seeing. What we're seeing up here is kind of a pretty printed version of it. This is really what came back. It's trying to pretty print it for us to make it a little bit easier. All this other junk is just my browser's adding that. But this is what really came back. This is the output. This here is the output of JSON underscore encode. I echoed it, of course, and that's why it comes out as the response to the thing. Okay? I hope you get that. Okay. So now what I want to do is I want to show you index.php, and this is the code that is running right here. It's index.php. So there's a bunch of stuff in here, but the interesting thing that it does is it loads jQuery, and then it calls document ready. This is the pattern to say, when the document's finally loaded, then run this code. And if you recall, when I did the post code, it said $post. This is a different thing that's kind of like $post, but it's called $getJSON, which means it's gonna do a get request and pull back to a URL and then pull back the data. Okay, so it's going to call the URL JSON.php, and then it's going to do a request. Then when the response comes back, it is going to call us and call us this function, the second parameter, which is our function, and call us and pass in the data. But the difference is this point, it's not a string. It's a JavaScript object or list, which means it's been parsed, right? So the curly brace in this case is an object with a variable, with a method, well, or with a key of first and second, okay? And so it's already parsed. And so then what I can do is I can just say data.first. And what is data.first? Well, that's the string that's the key first in the return JSON. And away we go. And we'll just console log it so we can kind of see it. So let me clear this, clear that. So if I view the network here, JavaScript console, if I view the JavaScript console, let me clear this, and then I'm gonna hit the refresh. So this index, let me just do a view source, view page source, there we go. So here we see it all, it loads jQuery, and it says when this document is done loading, then go grab some JSON, and then it's really only gonna, it's gonna put some stuff in here. Starts, the word before is in ID equals back, dollar back says go find the tag with the ID back, and changes HTML to data first. That's data sub first, I guess, is the best way to think about that. And it says before. And then it does some console messages. So watch this. It's going to be cool in slow motion. Let's see. Should I see the console messages or the network? Let's do the network. Now, I hope you can see this. It should take about a second. First thing, when I hit refresh, it's going to say before, and then a second later, it's going to turn to first thing. So watch when I hit refresh. It says before, now it's getting some JSON. Oh, it retrieved the JSON and pulled something out of the JSON. So if you look, the response to the original get had that string as before, and then it loaded jQuery because it had to, and then it called JSON, and got that variable, first thing, second thing, right? So first maps to first thing, second maps to second thing. And then if you look at the code, I simply go and say, go in, grab data.first, which is this string, because this is a string when it comes back from the server, but by the time it's coming in here, it has been parsed, and it's an object. Because the curly braces have been parsed. It's deserialized. It's parsed. And so just pull out data.first. And that's how first thing ends up here. And then if I go take a look at the log, you can see that this isn't we are logging data, which is the parameter that came back. But it is the JSON, but it's the converted JSON. It's converted to an object. And we console log it, and it's an object, and it has a key of first that maps to first thing, and a key of second that maps to second thing. So in just a few lines, I mean, it's very misleading that this is so few lines of code. I basically have, in one programming language, an object or an array of key, an associative array. With this line and this line, so I make an object in PHP, and then I do this, and then I have the same object converted to JavaScript. So I basically make objects in PHP, fire them out as JSON, pull them in to JavaScript as JSON, automatically parse them with the help of jQuery, and I just access the member variables that are in there, access the key value pairs that are in there. And so, in a sense, between here and here, there's a lot of work going on, a lot of work going on, but we don't have to worry too much about all that work. It's pretty dang impressive, actually, if you think about it. It's so much easier than serialization was like 10 years ago.